Morning, everyone. For you guys, anyway. Afternoon here. A little bit before 5 p.m. in Abu Dhabi. Make a slight camera adjustment there. Weigh-ins starting at the top of the hour. We'll carry those here. It's 5 p.m. local. Face-offs are scheduled for 7 p.m. local, which would be 11 a.m. Eastern, so we'll try to have those as well. Obviously not quite the hype around this card as there was UFC 251, but a couple of interesting matchups on here. I will be shooting video and photos. We'll have those up later at MMA Junkie, so a full highlights, full gallery as well. My man Simon Head is helping me back from in the UK, logging all these weights, sending all that out, so we'll have updated results over at MMA Junkie as well. So, like I said, just a couple minutes away, and we'll be getting started. UFC matchmaker Mick Maynard over there chilling in the corner. Staff is gathering, getting everything ready to go. John Anik's voice I hear over there. Mr. Anik on duty today too.
What's up, man?
What's up, kid? Doing all right? Yeah. Live video stream. I'll just give you, don't all talk right. bad about the wife right. or the kids or
yeah,
anything.
Yeah, that's good, yeah. Love you, honey. Quick turn.
Yeah. It's always kind of weird when you don't really get that time to process, right? So I feel kind of bad for everybody on this car because I think like when we did media day and stuff, like people are still kind of reliving the other one, you know? So it's a little tough, but gotta get these fights in. It's the tough one for us is this week because Wednesday, obviously, the fights end at like 8 in the morning, and then we got media day that night.
It was one less day in between.
Yeah, man. It's like 10 hours apart. It'll be tough. But then we get to next week, and it's like spaced out a little bit. So.
Thank thankfully for the UFC play-by-play role, it's like a physical impossibility to do three in a week because of all the voiceovers.
Right.
I knew I wasn't going to work the 18th.
Yeah.
I thought maybe they'd keep me and do the 25th.
Right. But, so you're just doing the first two and then heading out?
As long as I pass my which is no guarantee.
No guarantees.
All right, thank you all for coming out. Welcome to the official weigh-in for UFC Fight Night, Cater versus Ige. First fighter to the scale, taking part in the second UFC main event out of Methuen, Massachusetts, Calvin Cater. The official weight for Calvin Cater. Our next fighter to the scale, number 9 in the world at bantamweight, but competing at featherweight here tomorrow night. Please welcome Cody the Spartan Stamen. The official weight for Cody Stamen. Our next fighter to the scale, also in the UFC featherweight division, Lerone Murphy. The official weight for Lerone Murphy. All right, next up, UFC bantamweight division, we welcome back Aaron the Dragon Phillips. 135 for Aaron Phillips. All right, next up in the UFC flyweight division, Deanna Belbiza. $125 on the nose for Deanna Belbiza. All right, next up, back to the featherweight division, Ricardo Ramos. $145, the official weight for Ricardo Ramos. All right, staying in the featherweight division, please welcome Chris Fishgold. $149 for Chris Fishgold. All right, next up in the women's flyweight division, please welcome Meatball Molly McCann. $125 on the nose for the number 15th ranked contender, Molly McCann. Next up in the bantamweight division, Jack Shore. 136, the official weight for Jack Shore. Next up in the featherweight division, taking part in his first UFC main event, Dan 50K Ige. The official weight for Danny Ige. Next up, part of the co-main event in the UFC flyweight division, number 13 in the world, Tim Elliott. The official weight for Tim Elliott. Next up in the light heavyweight division, we say hello to Modestus Bukauskas. The official weight for Modestus Bukauskas. Next fighter to the scale in the featherweight division, Jared Flash Gordon. $145 for Jared Gordon. Next to the scale, half of our co-main event, the UFC flyweight division, please welcome Ryan Benoit. $126 for Ryan Benoit. All right, next fighter to the scale in the women's flyweight division, please welcome Liana Jojua. 126, the official weight for Liana Jojua. Next to the scale, set to make his UFC debut here tomorrow night, the light heavyweight division, he is Andreas Michailidis. The official weight for Andreas Michailidis. All right, next up, part of the feature division on ESPN and ESPN Plus, please welcome Khamzat Chimaev. For Khamzat Chimaev. All right, next up, first fight on the main card, the welterweight division. Please welcome Munir Lazez. The official weight for Munir Lazez. And his opponent, back for the first time in nearly 2 years, Abdul Razak Alhassan. The official weight for Abdul Razak Alhassan, 3 pounds over the welterweight limit.
Thank you.
All right, next fighter to the scale, the number 8 ranked bantamweight in the world competing at featherweight here tomorrow night, Jimmy Rivera. By the official weight for Jimmy Rivera.
Talk about your bosses.
You don't even know who I am under this mask.
No. We can tell by your gait.
Hey?
Your gait.
That's fine. That's why I'm walking.
Thank you. Thank you.
Patience. Next fighter to the scale, light heavyweight division, Jorge Gonzalez. The official weight for Jorge Gonzalez.
Thank you.
All right, next fighter to the scale in the women's flyweight division, Tyla Santos. .125, the official weight for Santos.
Yeah, he's off. He's out. Phillips waited. Oh, no, that's the last one.
She's the last one?
One, no, John Phillips. It literally... Sorry about that. We got you.
I wouldn't have just said that. I don't know.
By the way, to anybody that's watching, we have been able to confirm an MMA Viking report that Kenneth Berg will not be weighing in today. So Jorge Gonzalez just weighed in, basically, so he could get his show money for making weight. Kenneth Berg will not be weighing in. So that leaves us just one fighter left to weigh in at this time, John Phillips. Full results are up at MMA Junkie. I am working on photos right now. My man Ken Hathaway is helping process some videos. We'll have highlights, photo galleries, all that good stuff. But right now we are waiting on just one fighter, John Phillips. And then the face-offs are scheduled to be at 7 p.m. local, which is 11 a.m. Eastern.
Thank you. So
Yeah, I think we're supposed to get Dana too, though. Before I'm live there, but yeah, I think we're supposed to get Dana. So maybe after Dana, I don't know. I mean, it'll be a 2-minute clip, so it shouldn't take long. They just depend on time. Probably after Dana. That way, we're not like stuck in the middle or scrambling or whatever as everybody's packing up. But it won't take.
Like, no, yeah, no. I'm
hungry. Oh yeah, exactly. Trust me. Right there with you. What's up? I figured just ask about the reports of the 1.4 million pay-per-views. See if there's a Habib update. Just has been here. I'm gonna ask him about leaving the safe zone.
I was gonna ask him to be quiet right now. That's
top
stars.
Top three.
There's a lot going on. Three title fights. Five islands.
Yeah, yeah, maybe now, because you know he doesn't like to do it the night after, but maybe a couple days later you're like, all right. Who did?
Marvin Rose.
Oh, he said that? But he just tested positive.
Yeah, well, I know, but in the same interview.
Oh, he said it? He said, I'm going to work in October? Yeah. It's pretty much a done deal, right? Yeah.
True. But I mean, like, that's what you know. But I mean, if they're going to fight in October, why wouldn't it be started? If Yan said he can fight in October,
has to be.
Have one same card. Yeah.
I didn't read that interview. Is Mariah okay? Is he recovering? Or? Wow. Wow. I know, that's the thing we kind of talked about, like, almost overexposure, you know? But that's okay. A couple quick minutes, a couple quick highlights. Today's Connor's birthday?
Yeah.
How old is he now? Does he get any, like, huge party? Well, I guess you can't, right? Still can't gather and stuff, right? I don't know what the rules are. They're a bit further along. But clubs and stuff aren't open anywhere, are they? We couldn't do, like, a party appearance or whatever. I mean, you worked with McLaren.
He's only going to go.
Guys, as it stands, I'm all caught up now on the photo gallery. My man Ken Hathaway is working on the video. We're waiting on one more person to weigh in, that is John Phillips. And that will conclude our weigh-ins. Kenneth Berg not weighing in, medically ineligible for the contest. We don't have much further details than that. We do have face-offs at the top of the hour. If it continues like this, we'll just keep the stream open so you can check out the face-offs here as well. It doesn't look like we're gonna get a big gap in between. And then we should actually, we're told we'll have UFC President Dana White for a brief scrum after that as well. So as long as it looks like that's happening, we can kind of just leave this whole thing going, make it a big long event. Yeah, in this train, it looks like they're supposed to get Dana. We'll find out. John Phillips, did you hear?
awesome.
Yeah. The same they use.
They cook.
No, this is peanut butter and vegetables. It's healthy. Somewhat.
Ooh, it's a yeah. Yeah, you know. Yeah.
It'd be a lot worse. It's not like a garlic naan bread.
Nah, you're good.
Saturated in butter.
It's good bread too, by the way. Mm-hmm. Had it with a little hummus. Mmm.
Thank you.
Gone.
No, I'm going with a Wizard of Oz. But I didn't get the option to cross post.
Oh.
All right, guys, well, all caught up on work here, so I'll chill along with you here for the next 17 minutes or so while we wait for John Phillips to show up. Be our last person to weigh in. After that, the face-off should follow pretty much immediately after, and then we should have UFC President Dana White as well, so we'll just leave the stream open here. You guys can watch all of it, and then we'll have full highlights, photo galleries, all that good stuff later this afternoon. Eric, last one for me, Morgan. We do that as a courtesy to other journalists so the other journalists know, hey, I'm done. Especially now that we're all socially distanced and can't see each other. Are you going to? You always have to have the first word on every event. I don't know. If they ask me a question, I'll go for it. See the UFC staff over there in the corner hanging out. Sean Eck there. Excuse me. Woody, how many COVID tests have we taken on the island? I've taken 15 total. I've taken 3 since I got here. 4 total. Thank you, James. Much appreciated. Yeah, I think 4 here, but I've taken 15 total. But that goes back to May in Florida and then the ones we have to take. We have to take them each week at the Apex in Las Vegas as well. So we get quite a few. All right, TL. Don't forget Jesus. Nick Maynard there, almost cracking his phone. Antonio, no, Phillips has not weighed in yet. That's the last person we're waiting on. He looks like he's going to use every minute of it. Just 15 minutes left in the session. Tough one in the main event. I went with Danny Gaskazer. Probably just homer for the Vegas guy, man. We see him a lot in at Extreme Couture back home in Vegas. Joe Blow, I did one nasal test and the rest were the throat swabs. I don't like that nasal test. They give you the choice here which one you got. I don't like the nose, man. I'm not going to lie. It does not feel good. So I've been getting the throat swabs every time. Nah, that nasal one's not for me. yeah, James Cater was actually the first one on stage today. Actually the first one. How many fighters didn't make weight today? 2 didn't make weight. Abdulrazak Al-Hassan was one, Chris Fishgold was the other. All right, shout out to Emily. Straight from Adam Wells there. We got you, bro. If you want to check out the full results, go to MMA Junkie. But 2 fighters missed weight, and then Kenneth Berg never actually hit the scale, so that fight was scrapped. Cater's dangerous, man. No question about it, man. A lot of people feel like he's a future champion. TL Boss, UFC 4 opinions. It looks cool, man. I'm not a big video gamer, but it looks cool. Ace, that's the report with the 1.3 million. If we get Dana today, I was going to ask him to see if he'd confirm that as well. Pretty massive. I believe it, though. Traffic was good for us and for everybody we talked to, man. I think the interest around the world was high. You know, Fight Island was a big part of it, but come on, man. Adding Mazadon on a week's notice was big. Big, big, big. James, Max Holloway next. Good question, man. He could move up to lightweight if he wanted to, but I think he's still got fights at featherweight, man. I think they could do a third fight down the road. Colby versus Woodley in August. I want to see Colby versus Masvidal, if I'm being honest. I see what you did there, Michael Blanchard. Ace Jorge versus Connor, biggest pay-per-view of all time. Yeah, absolutely, man. I think that would be massive. I don't know if they could find a way to put it together, but that would just be absolutely massive. I think that it's crazy, right? Because it wouldn't even have to be for anything. Just the 5-round main event for the. For, I don't know. What would you have it for? Jiu-Jitsu already answered your question. You don't have to keep typing it over and over in all caps. Yeah, I guess put the BMF belt on. Well, I thought you'd have to make a new one. Didn't he say he's never going to defend that one? I mean, that's 1-1. He doesn't want to put that up for grabs. But, yeah, that would be cool to have for the BMF title. McCann versus Santos. That's a good one. I think I like McCann there. But we'll see how the fight plays out for sure. I think Masvidal won with 6 weeks camp. It's still a bad matchup for him, right? Like, I know everybody's low on Usman because he's not the most exciting fighter and all that. I get it. But, I mean, if you're Usman, why would you stand and trade? So, I just think that was always a bad matchup. But, I mean, certainly having more of an opportunity in training would be better. Martin, it's not that he didn't show up. It's just that he was ruled medically ineligible. Didn't read that whole question there. Something about the judges. I know there's been some complaints about it. Part of it might just be, you know, the travel, like who's available, who can go. It's a long time to be away from home. Michael Blankshain. Just chase your passion, man. Start covering local, I would say. I saw something about, are people afraid to ask questions? No. I don't know. Why would you be afraid? It's always silly when people say that. I like Gruff Hughes. I don't know if, you know, tomorrow's going to make him the next big thing, but, man, Jack Shore is incredibly talented. Felix Alvarado, I loved Makwan Americani, man. I think I thought that was a great performance. I've always been a fan of Makwan. Fishgold, I don't know. I don't know that he looked, you know, you say, does he look drained? I will say that, you know, this era where everybody has to wear a mask, it is kind of a little bit harder to see how they look. I mean, he wasn't like about to pass out on the way, you know? But it is harder to kind of see their whole face and to kind of getting on the Izzy versus Costa. No, haven't heard a schedule yet. I'm thinking October, but we'll see. By the way, I'm seeing some movement, so maybe John Phillips is here. I'm thinking maybe October. I think we're going to be back here in October if I had to guess. That's pure guess. But I think we're going to be back here in Fight Island in October, and I think that would make sense for it. Sorry, I was looking over at the side trying to see what's going on. You can see Matt Valenzuela getting in her place. Looks like maybe we're ready. I see some cameras over on the side. All right, I think I got in our last person here. Here we go. Yep, here we go.
All right, assume your positions. Final flight into the scale in the middleweight division, John Phillips. 186 for John Phillips.
Say John Phillips was a little excited to make weight there. That was funny. I'm gonna get these files over. I'm just gonna let this run because we're only talking about like 6 minutes. So I'll just leave this open and we should have the face offs right at the top of the hour. Thank you.
did.
Set back up here. Looks like they're lining people up just off camera to the outside, so we'll have our face-offs here. And like I said, we've been told we'll have UFC President Dana White right after as well, so if that happens, we'll just leave this up and running as well. Yeah, David, you had two fighters miss weight, one fight scratched as well. If you want to go to MMA Junkie, you can see the full results there. They're up at MMA Junkie. Seems like just about everybody in place. Security's in place. Cameras are in place. So, imagine we're getting started here pretty quick. I wonder if we're. Told Dana was going to talk to us afterwards. I haven't actually seen him yet, unless maybe that's what they're waiting on, is to get him in here as well. I do see McMaynard over there, who could obviously do the face-offs.
Yeah.
TO boss. Thoughts on Francis Ngannou? Dangerous, obviously, man. Continues to develop. Seems to be getting better. I like his opportunities down the line to be a heavyweight champion for sure. Don't start with that. The howling madness. Come on now. It's played out. Dana versus Oscar. He's definitely not an Oscar De La Hoya fan, is he? Is DC the GOAT? To me, man, it's got to be John Jones. Nick, face-off should start almost immediately. Hans, what's going on, Hans? No, the sleep schedule's whack. Just trying to get a couple hours here and there when we can. It's difficult. Struggling to sleep through the night, but it's all good. That's why you use the rankings at MMA Junkie, Matthew. Don't use those UFC rankings. Head on over to MMA Junkie. Use those rankings. But yeah, whoever was asked earlier, we should start like any minute now. We're just... since there's not a broadcast schedule, I think they can kind of go whenever. This Usman, the next goat. He looks tough to beat, doesn't he? Now, that's not going to make people happy. I know people like to complain, but man, he's difficult. Tough to beat him. What's up, Lorenzo from France? Hopefully, one of these days, we'll get to have our first UFC event in France. Will Dana versus Oscar happening? No. Hello from Canada. Nice. Alex, nice to see the respect for Usman. But see, right below you, somebody says, Usman is born. Conor will KO the F out of Usman. People don't like Usman, but man, he's a really great fighter, man. It's tough to question what he does. Brazil in the house. Habib is the GOAT. Hey, man, there's an argument to be made, right? That undefeated record speaks for itself, man. It really does, and obviously ripped to his father as well. Be interesting to see what he does here. Costa versus Augie? Was that supposed to be Izzy? I'm going to ask today what the holdup is. Obviously, no announcements yet, but if we do speak with Dana, I'll definitely just going to ask him because everybody's asking about that fight. Adam, I believe Conor McGregor will fight again. I really do. Who's been dominant, but I don't pay a cent to see him. So it's active. But I hate to say it, but I know you're probably not alone in that thought. DeSalas, I do think he won against Dominic Reyes. Very, very close, but I do think he won the fight. And also, I think sometimes with rankings, I mean, you do have to respect the results, right? Iowa. I don't know. Are there big arenas in Iowa? I'm sure there are, right? There's got to be something. Aldo versus Cruz. Since they're coming off bantamweight losses, I don't hate that idea at all. Poirier versus Ferguson. Winner gets Habib Gaethje. Winner. I think if Poirier wants it, remember he said he wanted to take some time off, and you know maybe wait till next year. So I think it all depends on schedules. But as far as the schedules line up, then hell yeah, that's a great fight. Habib versus Justin, winner fights Connor. Potentially. I mean, that's the idea. That's what the UFC wants, I think. Yair and Zabit. A lot of people excited for Yair and Zabit. That'll be a great fight. Max 3, not for now, not right now, definitely. Zabit doesn't want 5 rounds. Spann versus Johnny Walker. Dig that. thoughts on Jimmy Rivera at 145. I don't think that's a long term. I could be wrong. I don't think that's a long term move though. David, how can you say the game is trash when it hasn't even come out yet? It'll be the stare downs, Aiden. Yeah, the weigh-ins are in the books. If you want full results, head on over to MMA Junkie. We got them all there. Oh, the beta's out already? Oh, that's cool. Hans, no news on Berg yet. I know the beta's out. I don't really get. The game looks exactly the same. It's terrible. You guys are, man. Y'all, I was so excited. The preview looked cool. I'm not even a big gamer, but I was excited. It looked cool. Fighting in the backyard, fighting in the Kumite. Oh well. It's something for me and my son to play. So he's starting to get into video games. Well, hell, everybody is, I guess, with stuck inside in the pandemic. So. I'll probably end up playing it anyway. No insider info on Connor, no. Same thing. I think he's waiting, trying to figure it out. Joe Duffy ever claw back to McGregor? I don't think he really wants that fight again, which is weird. Always thought he should try to cash in on it. It's his birthday. Yeah, we'll see you in the... Oh! Alright. There's Dana here. Let's get this thing started.
Alright, thank you all for coming out. Good to see Dana White back here. Let us get you started. UFC Fight Night Cater versus in-game wall-to-wall on both ESPN and ESPN+. All right, first prelim comes your way in the bantamweight division. It'll be Jack Shore versus Aaron Phillips. Next up, in the women's flyweight division, Deanna Belpizza versus Liana Jojua. UFC featherweight division, Jared Flash Gordon versus Chris Fishgold. Next prelim in the light heavyweight division, Modestus Bukauskas versus Andreas Mihailidis. Next fight in the UFC featherweight division, Ricardo Ramos versus Lerone Murphy. All All right, and the featured prelim in the middleweight division, John Phillips versus Khamzat Chimaev. Now we get to the main card live on ESPN and ESPN Plus. Main card opener comes your way in the welterweight division. Abdul Razak Al-Hassan versus Munir Lazeez. In the women's flyweight division, 15th ranked Molly McCann versus Tyla Santos. Featured bout in the featherweight division, Jimmy Rivera versus Cody Stamann. Flyweight, Tim Elliott versus Ryan Benoit. Your main event for UFC Fight Night in the featherweight division, 6th ranked Calvin Kattar versus number 10 Dan Ige. It shapes up as tomorrow night. Thank y'all for coming out. We'll see you in about 24 hours.
I don't know. They said we were, but I'm not sure. I don't see a microphone going up. There's one over there? Push, just come forward a little bit. Over there. Okay, there we go. I was just going to say, I didn't see a microphone. That was funny. No worries. All right. Yeah, all right. It looks like we are getting Dana, so we'll... Dana.
Chest on two.
on, just grab that. There we go. Dana's heading to the stage right now, so we'll get the scrum started.
What's up, guys?
The big question everybody has is, did you get your house yet? Have you found
the house? Today. That's what I was doing all day today. I was looking. Not yet. Saw a couple things I like, but not yet.
We saw you and Bisping and Sarah, you guys got to go outside the safe zone a little bit. How do you guys get approved to do that? How does that work, that you guys can head out of the bubble and that sort of thing? Can we get approved?
Yeah. We're stuck here, unfortunately. We're filming a show yesterday, so we went out and we did some fun things. How do we get to do it?
Yeah, does it require there's so much over the top stuff here, just curious.
We knew we were doing that when we came. You know, same protocol. Everybody that we were in contact with, and everybody that had anything to do with us was tested multiple times. I mean, realistically, Abu Dhabi is the safest place in the world. You know, leaving the safe zone is because they don't want us to leave the safe zone. That's what that has to do with. They don't want us outside of the safe zone, all those things going on. But, you know, we got some stuff worked out, and, you know, they made sure that everybody that we were in contact with was tested multiple times.
Very cool.
And I think we're aware of how many times I've been tested.
I know you don't always talk numbers, but there was a report that came out this week that UFC 251 did north of 1.3 million pay-per-view buys. I'm curious if you can confirm that report, and if you might want to take a victory lap of sorts, if that's the number.
Well, it was a very successful event, and you know, we're happy. This thing killed it across the board in every way you could possibly kill it, so it went really well.
What do you take out of it? I mean, when you post a number like that, that's one of the biggest ever. I mean, what lessons do you take out of it? Was it Masvidal's addition? Is it, you know, Fight Island? I mean, what lessons did you take out of it?
Well, I said it to you guys the other night. I think when you put on a fight, you know, a successful promotion of an event, you know, it's this big melting pot of different things. You know, Fight Island was a massive star in this thing. Masvidal was a massive star. Obviously, Usman, you know, the champion and the guy that, you know, we're all starting to realize is tough to beat, and a great card underneath it. And, you know, it all came together perfectly, and it was a major success. Everybody's healthy. I mean, it's all good. Nice. Literally not one negative thing that I could point out. You know, as I've been talking to people, especially here from Abu Dhabi that were involved in the event, you know, I've had meetings since the fight, and they're like, well, what could we do better next time? I'm like, I wish I could tell you something negative. I wish I could tell you something that didn't go perfect and that wasn't perfect. Everything here has been perfect. And when you think about this safety zone that we're in, from the restaurants to the, you know, the hotels and the service and everything else, it literally could not be done better than this. If you look at all the other places, California just shut down again, you know, and what's going on in the States, you couldn't execute a better event with better facilities, with better, you know, food for everybody, and the list just goes on and on.
Yeah.
It could not be better.
I would agree with that. I know that we've got 3 fight cards left, but people are already starting to talk about when we come back here. You've got some fighters saying that they've heard maybe October that they'll be fighting out here. Are you ready to say, yes, we're going to have another run of events out here in October?
Not officially. Not officially. But yes, we're going to have another run of events out here. I mean, it's just, if you look at what's going on in the world, like I told you guys before, I don't see this light, you know, changing anytime soon.
Yeah. We turn around from the pay-per-view. We got a Wednesday night fight card right away. How did this come together, to put one together? Was it just because you're trying to capitalize on Fight Island, or do you see more midweek events happening in the future with ESPN? How did this come together?
What do you mean?
For doing a Wednesday event. I mean, it's happened before, but it's not something that happens a lot. So is this something we'll see on Fight Island, or are we going to see more of this in the schedule?
Well, you know, we're still catching up with our schedule, too. So we caught up with our schedule in the United States, and now we have to catch up with our schedule here. I guess what you could call the rest of the world, with these international events. Because off the top of my head, I can't remember, but we were supposed to be doing Brazilian show, Australian show, and, you know, all these different shows that were supposed to happen. You know, we owe all these kids fights. We gotta get these kids fights.
Yeah. While you've been out here, have you had a chance to speak with Habib yet and catch up with him and see how he's doing?
No, I'm not messing with Habib. I'm leaving him alone until he's ready to talk, and letting him mourn and, you know, do what he has to do. I reached out to him, you know, the day of, and I haven't heard back from him since, so.
I know the tentative plan was to maybe have him fight in September. I mean, that's already just like 2 months away. Do you think that's off the table at this point, or is it still a possibility?
I don't think it's off the table. Okay. Just waiting to hear from him.
And last thing for me, the one that everybody's hammering me about, Adesanya Costa. We know the fight's happening. We just haven't gotten an announcement. What's the holdup, and when can we expect to know when that fight's going to take place?
Well, there's no holdup. We just haven't done it yet. There's no holdup. We're focused on this here, on Fight Island. It's like, I'm not, I'm not thinking about anything else other than this right now. We have fights laid out till, where's Mick? Did he leave? Yeah. Mick looks like he's been laying by the pool. We have fights laid out till October, so our schedule's already made. We're way ahead of this thing, and when it's time, we'll announce it.
Hey, Dana. I know there was a lot of things that went into the success of UFC 251, but does it cement Masvidal as one of your biggest stars?
Does it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. He's a big star.
Marlon Moraes said that he has accepted a fight with Cody Garbrandt in October. Does that leave the path open for Aljamain Sterling to get a title shot at PGO?
Yeah, I don't know. We haven't pulled that trigger yet.
But would there be anyone else in that division apart from Sterling that makes a logical choice right now?
I don't know. I'm not even thinking about it. If you guys ask me about any other fighters or any other fights, I'm not even there.
And last one for me, it's Conor McGregor's birthday today. I wonder if you've had any sort of dialogue with him since his retirement and if you've spoken to him at all.
I'm sorry, what's the question?
It's Conor McGregor's birthday today, so I thought I'd take the opportunity to ask you, have you spoken to him at all since his retirement and have you had any dialogue with him?
No. None. Happy birthday, Conor. Cheers.
Speaking of another writer that has announced the retirement, Amanda Nunes, have you ever talked to her? Because you mentioned that you're planning on talking to her about the future.
Amanda Nunes? Have I talked to her about her future?
Yeah.
I haven't. No, we haven't talked. Yeah. My whole focus has been here.
Okay, so speaking about the other fights, on Sunday you were very happy with the judges. Are you planning on doing on changing anything on that aspect? The judges and referees?
No. Whatever we had planned for here is planned, you know? And no matter who you bring in or what you do, there's always the possibility of bad decisions, you know? Did you guys see today that FanDuel, if you bet with FanDuel, they gave you your money back on Max Holloway. Yeah, it's pretty crazy. So that there goes to show you.
Yeah, last one for me. You have mentioned many times that you're planning on sharing your protocol with other leagues. Bellator's coming back later this month. Would you be willing to share your protocols with them as well?
We sent to many other MMA organizations. I doubt Bellator is going to be calling me asking me for any protocols. But sure, yeah, we would.
Hi, Dana. I just found out that Davidson's still flying over here. He's still on the plane. Are you still concerned about his weight?
Yes. I was concerned about his weight anyway.
So. He's not going to have a lot of time.
Yeah. We're always concerned about his weight.
Also, Jessica Andrade, is she still here? And she said that she might sub if some fighter maybe doesn't make weight or something happens. Are you concerned about the female fighters?
Jessica
Andrade, she said that she might
sub. Yeah, Jessica. Yeah, she hit me up and said, I'm already training again. I'm ready to go. She's a little beast. Am I concerned about? No, I'm not concerned about somebody, and we need her for backup, but that's just her mentality, and that's just what a little badass she is. Yeah, she hit me up too and said, I'm ready to fight again if you need me.
Last one for me, Nevada shut down, California shut down today again. Are you concerned about the Vegas shows?
Yes.
Do you have a backup plan?
Thinking about it now. I mean, my backup plan would be White Island. You know, might be living here.
Is it doable to do all those events here, the August ones? Is it possible to bring those events here next month?
Anything is possible. If Nevada shuts down and doesn't allow us to do fights in Nevada, yeah, I'm going to be spending a lot of time in Abu Dhabi. I can't hear when you have the mic.
Would you push back a little bit? I mean, if the fight shuts down, if the planning commission doesn't allow on the Apex, would you have to push back maybe some weekends?
I hope not. No, I mean, listen, we've proved that we can do these things in Nevada or anywhere safely. So hopefully we get to keep doing what we do in Nevada, and we can keep coming to Abu Dhabi for international fights. You know, that's not what I'm hoping. So. But yes, I'm thinking about what happens if we get shut down and what's next.
Dana, just one more. this year you've spent so much money on all the COVID tests and all the protocols you've had to do, but you've also been the only sport able to go. In terms of your business this year, how successful is the UFC doing?
The brand has never been bigger or stronger than it is right now. I mean, if you look at the ratings and the amount of promotion and the amount of, I mean, I don't know if you guys felt it the other day, like we felt it, but you had to feel it in your business. My social media, my personal social media was off the charts, the biggest numbers that I've ever pulled, ever. UFC's social media numbers are off the charts. The traffic, I told you guys the other day, merchandise, we've already sold more merchandise this year than we did all of 2019. We already crushed that number from 2019. And the list goes on and on. So, you know, obviously in a lot of ways this has affected our business. There's no gate. That's $110 million in that ballpark. And some other things, but we're still rolling and we're seeing, you know, you have to look at the value that's being built in the brand, the amount of people that you're probably converting to be, you know, fans that probably never watched before, and the list goes on and on. But we're gonna do a full analysis of the brand and what's going on right now with the sport.
So really, you'll only be able to know how successful this year was, like maybe 2 years when everything's back to normal, and you can see how many people you retained from this year and this attention.
Yeah, listen, it's impossible for it not to be good. It's all a good thing. So there's more people that are aware of this sport than ever before, and not just in the United States, but globally.
Sorry, one more. You've said how amazed you were by looking at Amanda Ribas performing.
Yeah.
Do you think she looks better at 115 or 125?
She looks great at both. I mean, it's hard to criticize her in any way, shape, or form. She's incredibly talented and has an amazing personality. She's got the whole package.
Dana, last one. Susie, the UFC makeup artist, she announced, I think, last week that she has breast cancer and she started a GoFundMe. A lot of fighters are voting for her. Do you have any status on her? The UFC also helping her?
I've been helping her for 5 years. And we've been helping her for 5 years. But I don't have any, no, I don't have any updates on her, but yeah. Cool. Thank you, guys.
All right, that's a wrap. Full galleries, highlights, all that good stuff up at MMA Junkie. Full coverage of this as well. Thanks to everybody for tuning in. Fights tomorrow.